In the last lecture, we have discussed about the block diagram reduction technique for solving the transfer function. Then we have seen that if the system is simple, in that case there is no issue, because in every step we will have to reduce the block, and we need to redraw all the block diagram by doing the elimination of summing point or some closed loop system. There, if we have so many blocks, for example, if we have so many takeoff points in the system along with so many blocks, then in that case, going with the block diagram reduction technique, that will really consume more time as well as it will be tedious to solve. So there is a simple method that is introduced by S.J. Mason to solve such type of complex circuits or the complex system by giving the graphical representation, and it is called as signal flow graph. Basically, this signal flow graph, this is the graphical representation which gives the relationship between the variables of set of linear algebraic equations. As we have discussed that we have transferred the time domain differential equations into the frequency domain algebraic equations. So those algebraic equations will be solved by using this signal flow graph method, in which the system variables, we are talking about the variables. So the system variables in signal flow graphs, these are represented by nodes, and these nodes are connected by a directed line segment. That line segment, this is called as branch. Now we'll discuss this in detail, means how the signal flow graph will work for solving the complex control system. Where we have the input as R, there is a summing point over here. We have the gains G1, G2, output is C, there is a feedback path with gain H. Say this is negative feedback, so the sign is negative, and here we have this as positive. Now in this case, this is the block diagram representation of the system. Now how to convert this into a signal flow graph? We need to decide the variables. Let us say this is one variable, that is input variable, so we can mark this as one of the node. This is considered as one of the node because this is the output of certain point. Here we are going to have some values, so we will mark this as a node. Here again we have this block with again G1, so this G1 multiplied by the signals over here, that will be the output of this block, so we will also mark this as one of the variable, so it is node. This is also a node, and here we are going to have another node. So we will call these nodes as, this is node out, since input is R, so we call this as R. This is the error signal, so let us call it as E. Say this is A. Since C is already there, so we cannot call this as B, let us call this as C, and this point as B. Now we will mark these nodes over here. So this is R. Here we have E. This is A. Here we have C. And somewhere here we will mark this as B. So these are the nodes. Now just see, from R to E, if we travel from R to E, the signal which is reaching over here at E, that is the difference between the R and B. So since here we do not have any gain, so this is unity gain, so this is 1. So we mark a branch between R and E with the gain 1. So this is the representation in the SFG. So this is a directed line which is joining the two nodes, that is R and E, and the gain is 1. Similarly, from B to E, we have the sign is negative but the gain is 1. So we mark this as, let us consider this is the signal, this is minus 1. So the gain is 1 with a negative sign. Then E to A, this is the direction, so this is the direction in the block diagram position, and the gain is G1. Similarly, from A to C, the gain is G2, and from C to B, we have the gain as H. So it will be like this. This is H. So this is the normal signal flow graph of this block diagram reduction, block diagram of a control system. So this is signal conversion from block diagram to the SFG. Now we will have to see. This is simply the conversion from block diagram to the signal flow graph. Now we'll see how to use this signal flow graph for determining the transfer function. Basic task is to get the transfer function. So this is to be determined. So now there are some definitions that we need to know before we go for all these expressions. So the number one is mode. Basically, it represents the system variables. This mode represents the system variables. Just now we have seen that these are the nodes which are representing the variables. So this node, it is a system variable, and the value of each node is identified as summation of the value of node is defined as the summation of all the incoming signals. Summation of incoming signals to the node. So here, if you consider this E as one of the node, then the value of this E is given as R multiplied by 1 and P multiplied by minus 1. So here, the value for E is equals to 1 multiplied by R plus minus 1 multiplied by B. So this will give the value as R minus B. So this is the value of E. There is no effect of outgoing signal on the value of any node, because outgoing signal simply fetches the information and it passes this information to another node. So here the value is obtained by just taking the summation of all the incoming signals to that particular node. And here we have these nodes as R, E, A, C, B. All are these nodes. Now second one is branch. Branch is simply a directed line segment. Branch is a directed line segment that joins the two nodes or that connects the two nodes in a particular way. Then number three is input node. Input node, it is a node where we have only outgoing signals. Because since we are calling as the input node, that means we are giving the signal to a particular system. So here, if we consider that this R is as input node, so from here we are simply giving the signal to the block. So in this case, we can say that input node is a node where we have only the outgoing signals. So only outgoing signals are available at node. Outgoing signals alone means no input signals. So for outgoing signals alone, so here the example is R. R is the input node. Then fourth one is output node. In output, basically if this is the block where we are applying the input, let us say this is X, the gain can be anything, and here we are getting the resultant as Y. Let us say the gain is k. So y equals to k times of x. This is the requirement of the particular system. So here, in this case, x, since x is the input, so here we have the outgoing signal. That means the signal is going to the block which has the gain of k. And y is the output. That means here, whatever is the resultant of output of this particular block with gain k, that will be obtained at node Y. That means Y is the node which is having only incoming signals. When there will be no outgoing signals at the output node. So, wherever we have only incoming signals, that node is considered to be the output node. Now just see, try to identify the node, output node in this signal flow graph. Here, C seems to be the output node because just now we have converted the block diagram into the signal flow graph, and we know that in this block diagram representation of the system, C is the output. That is why we are knowing that C is output. But here, just now we are seeing that output node is a node where we have only incoming signals. There will be no outgoing signals. But in this case, what is happening over here? At this particular node C, we have incoming signal, that is G2A, and we also have the outgoing signals, that is HC. So now, in this case, this definition is fit. And so we cannot say that definition will work everywhere. We can say that this is the limitation to the Meissen's gain formula or the signal flow graph given by the Meissen, but he has also overcome the limitation of this and has suggested that whenever we have the case or whenever we have the situation where the output node we are getting, where we have outgoing signals along with the incoming signals, there we can extend this line with the unity gain and we may call this as C. If we extend this point from here to this point with a gain 1, the result is not going to change because at this particular point the result is G2 times of A. Right? Here also we are having the resultant G2 times of A. So whatever was earlier going to the B, the same thing is again going to the B. But instead of calling this point as C, now we will call this as C. Now see the output node. Now here we have seen that C is the output, it has only incoming signal, that is gain 1. So now this is perfectly alright. So whenever we have the case where at the output node we have the incoming as well as outgoing, we will have to extend the node by using a directed time segment with a gain of 1 like this. So this is about the output node. The number 5 is chain node. Chain node is the node where we have incoming signals as well as outgoing signals. So in this case, incoming as well as outgoing signals are available. Incoming and outgoing signals. So in this case, you can say, here of course this is C. The chain nodes are, at E we have incoming signals as well as outgoing signals. At A we have incoming signals as well as outgoing signals. At B, we have incoming signal as well as outgoing signal. Now, we cannot say that C is chain node. Reason being, we are calling this C as output node and just now we have extended, so the position of C is changed. Now, instead of this, now this particular node is called as C and here we have only outgoing incoming signals, so this cannot be considered to be the chain node. So, the chain nodes are only E, A and B. So these are the chain nodes because these are the nodes E and B where we have incoming signals as well as outgoing signals. The number 6 is path. It is an unidirectional transversal of connected branches such that we need to copy this so that we will not forget this because the path, it is an unidirectional transversal of connected branches such that no node is passed more than once. So path, it is an unidirectional transversal of connected branches such that no node is passed more than once. In this case, we can say that path is R, E, A, C. So this characteristic will be path, R-E-A-C. Even we can say that E to A, this is one path. Even we can say that A-C-B, this is also the path. So the path can be E to A, or we can say this as R-E-A-C. This is the path. In both the cases, we have each node only for one time. So this is path. Now the next one is the forward path. Seventh one is forward path. Forward path, the name itself suggests that it is a path which travels from input node to the output node. It travels from input node to output node. So in this signal flow graph, we have only one forward path, that is R E A C. So the forward path that we have in the signal flow graph is R E A C. The number 8 is loop. Loop is the path which originates and terminates at the same node. This is called as loop. There may be so many loops, right? If it is originated over here, then it should be terminated at this point only. So loop is the path where we have the origination and termination at the same node. So here we have a loop as, you can start over here at E. So E, A, C, B, E. So we can say in the signal flow graph it is E, A, C, B, E. Or you can change the position of this like A, C, B, E, A. That's one and the same thing. So this is about the loop. Then number 9, self loop. It is a loop where we have only one branch, or it is a loop with single branch. When we talk about the single branch, now you can think of how we are going to have a loop with single branch. Because if we have two nodes anywhere, for connecting these two nodes, we must have a branch. Right? If we connect it like this, then this cannot be considered to be a loop because this is open. It is going from one node to another node. This is not closed loop. We can have this self loop with single branch only in the case if the node is common for the origination and termination. That means the system must have only one node. So it is like this. So here it has some gain, right? It is originated at this point and it is also connected at this point without going through any other node. So this is called as self loop. And here we have only one branch, that is single branch. Then number 10, it is non-touching loop. If we have more than one loop, of course in this signal flow graph we have only one loop. If in the system we have more than one loop, and if those loops are not having any common node, then those are called as non-touching loop. So let's take the example, let us say these are the nodes connected by the branches. And here there is a loop. It is going like this. And second loop is like this. So here in this case, what is happening? This is one loop, this is another loop. But they don't have any common node because these two are separated over here. So these are called as two non-touching loops. They may have for several combinations of non-touching loops, two non-touching loops, three non-touching loops, and so on. In this case, with this example, we can say that this particular system is having two non-touching loops because they don't have any common node. Now we'll see what is forward path gain. It is the product of branch gain encountered while traveling from input node to the output node. It is a product of branch gain encountered while traveling from input node to the output node or through the forward path. So in this case, let us say P, since we have only one forward path, so let's mark it as P1. P is for forward path gain. So P1 is given as 1, because this is 1. Here we have this 1, so first we'll write it as 1. Multiply by G1, that is the second one, so this is G1. Second is G2, so here we have G2. And we are actually with 1, there is no need to write, but here if you write, there is no issue. So this is G1, G2. So this is the forward path gain that we have for our signal flow graph. Now number 12 is loop gain. Again, it's a product of branch gain encountered by traveling in a loop. So here we have only one loop, that is EA, CB, E. So here, let us start from E. So the loop L11, we'll see, right, we'll take the example for the SFG, we'll see why this is denoted as 11. So L11, for that being, we have said this is L11, L stands for loop L11, we'll see why this notation is in use. So L11 is given as, it is G1, G2, H, and then minus 1. We are starting from here. So G1 is the first branch gain, product with second branch gain, product with third one, product with fourth one. So it is G1, G2, H, minus 1. So here, we take this minus sign over here, so it is G1, G2, H. So this is the value of L1, 1. Now number 13 is the Bessel's gain formula. This formula is given as T summation K, this is PK del K divided by del, this is equals to P1 del 1 plus P2 del 2 plus PK del K divided by del. So this is the expression as we use for the Bessel's gain formula. This is the Bessel's gain formula. Summation of k, product of pk del k, that is p1 del 1 plus p2 del 2 plus dash 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 up to pk del k divided by del, where this pk is gain of k forward path, del is determinant of the graph, that is signal flow graph. This del is determinant of the graph, and del is obtained as, by using the formula, 1 minus sum of gains of all individual loops plus sum of gain product of all possible combination of two non-touching loops. Minus, you can write here, sum of gain products of all possible combinations of three non-touching loops, and so on. If you have further combinations of non-touching loops like 4, 5, 6, then you can simply make the sign as alternate. So 1 minus, then this is positive, this is negative, then positive, and similarly, we can go on changing the alteration of this symbol. Means alternate element of positive negative sign will be there. So this is del. That is del equals to 1 minus sum of gates of all individual loops. We are seeing the loops. It is like this. Something like this. So these are the individual loops. Sum of gate products of all possible combinations of two non-touching loops. Let us consider these are the non-touching loops because we don't have any common mode. Let us consider here we have some common mode at this layer. So in this case, these are not called as non-touching loops. But of course, if you compare this loop with this, then these two are non-touching loops. So we have written it as sum of gate products of all possible combinations of two non-touching loops. So these two are two non-touching loops, these two are two non-touching loops, these two are non-touching loops, these two are non-touching loops, these two are also non-touching loops. So we are looking the combinations of these two different many combinations of the possible combination of two non-touching loops. Similarly, these are the sum of gain products of all possible combination of three non-touching loops. Now in this case, let us say this is 1, this is 2, and this is 3. All these three loops are non-touching loops. So this is one combination. Second one, this is 1, this is 2, let us say 4. So 1, 2, 4, this is also making one. And other combinations, we cannot have this as 1, 3, 4 because this 3 and 4 are touched together. So we are talking about those things. So I think this is clear why we are calling as individual or 2 non-touching or 3 non-touching. Individual loops, 1, 2, 3, 4. All these loops are called as individual loops. When we talk about the two non-touching loops, combination of non-touching loops, then you can see that where we must not have any common mode. So here there is no common mode between 1 and 3, there is no common mode between 1 and 2, there is no common mode between 1 and 4, there is no common mode between 2 and 3, there is no common mode between 2 and 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So there are 5 two non-touching loops. For 3, 1, 3 and 2, 1, 2 and 3, these are non-touching loops. So we can say this is one combination of three loops which are not touching together because all the nodes are separate. Similarly, 1, 2 and 4, these are another combination. So we have two, three non-touching loop combinations over here. That is 1, 2, 3 and 1, 2, 4. I think this is clear now how to use this signal flow graph for obtaining the value of delta. Now we are left with del k. What is del k? Basically, this del k is the value of del for that part of the graph which is not touching the kth forward path. So this is del k. Del k is what? It's a value of del for that part of the graph that which is not touching the k forward path. Now we take one example, one of the simple example where we can apply this signal flow graph analysis, and by using this Mason's gain formula we will obtain the transfer function or the overall gain. So we write one question. First of all, we will see the first type of operation, that is construction of SFG, that is signal flow graph, from the given set of equations, and hence determination of transfer function. So this is the type first where we are using the construction of SFG from the given set of equations. Means we have set of algebraic equations. With the help of those equations we will plot the SFG, and then we will use the Wessel's gear formula for finding out the transfer function. Now we see the question. Number one, consider a system described by the following set of equations. X2 equals to A12 x1 plus A32 x3 plus A42 x4 plus A52 x5. Mark this as equation number 1. X3 equals to A23 x2. Mark this as equation number 2. X4 equals to A34 x3 plus A44 x4. Mark this as equation number 3. X5 equals to A35 x3 plus A45 x4. Mark this as equation number 4. Where x1 is input variable, x2 is output variable. Construct signal flow graph SFG and hence find overall gain. That means we need to find T equals to x5 over x1, because the transfer function is output over input. X2 is output. Here we can mark this as x5 instead of x2. This is x5. So x1 is input variable and x5 is output variable. So the transfer function is x5 over x1 by Meissen's gain formula. Now here, we have a set of equations. We need to construct the signal flow graph by using this algebraic equations. Now, we can see the variables. We have the variables as x2, x3, x4, x5, and these are in terms of also x1. That means we have the total number of variables as x1, x2, x3, x4, x5, that is 5, where x1 is the input and x5 is the output. So let us plot the signal flow graph. Here, we will mark this as x1. Now, let us arrange this in sequence. So x1, this is x2. Here, we can mark this as x3. Here, let us say this is x4. And the output is x5. Now, we write the scale equation. x2 equals to a12 x1. So this is the gain, a12. So we have one directed line from x1 to x2 with a gain a12. Now, A2 equals to A32 X3. Right? So it is going in the reverse direction. So first of all, let us consider the X3. So X3 equals to A23 X2. Lower to higher side. First we will take care of the lower to higher side. So X3 equals to A23 times of X2. So we are taking care of this term. We are taking care of this term. Now X4 equals to A34 times of X3. So the line will go from X3 to X4, and this is A34. Now X5 is equals to A45 X4. This is the nearest variable. So from X4 to X5, we have a directed line where we have the gain of A45. Now X2 equals to A12 X1 plus A32 X3. That means we are having one feedback signal from X3 to X2. That means it is making a loop. So here, from X3 to X2, we plot a directed line, that is a branch, with a gain. This is A32. So at X2, we have this. Now, A42 X4. From X4, we are having one feedback to the X2. So A4 to X4. So from here we have another loop which is coming to the X2. We can call this as, so it is like this. This is A4 2. The gain is A4 2. So we are taking care of this. Now again we have to do, that is A5 to X5. So we have one more loop that is going from this point. It is A5 2. So now see the expression X2. X2 equals to A1 to X1. That means this A1 to X1 plus A3 to X3. So this is A3 to X3. Then A4 to X4. This is A4 to X4. Then A5 to X5. This is A5 to X5. Basically this is the value of the node. We are talking about the node X2. Each variables are represented as a node. So X2 is not the node. The value of this node is given as the sum of all the input signals at that node. We have discussed about this in the definition. And exactly we are following the same thing. That at this node X2, we are having the summation of all the incoming signals. Now about X3 we have already done. For X4, A3 for X3, now A4 for X4. We have this as A4 for X4, that means this is self loop. It is starting from X4, because this is A4 5 X4, and it is terminating at X4 itself, so this will be X4. This is loop, so it is A4 4. Now X5, this is equals to A4 5 X4 plus A3 5 X3. Now, there is a signal from X3 to X5. So it will be like this. It is going from X3 to X5 with a gain of A3 5. So if you see this variable X5, that is the value of node X5, it is A3 5 X3 plus A4 5 X4. This is A3 5 X3 and A4 5 X4. So this is the construction of signal flow graph with the help of the set of linear algebraic equations 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Hence, total 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. There are total 9 terms and we have total 9 branches. And each branch will have the gain which is mentioned over here in the linear equation. So, this is a checkpoint. Plotting or after constructing the signal flow graph, you can count the number of branches and compare it with the number of terms that you have in this set of algebraic equations. If these two are matching, you have done perfectly all right. Now, let us follow the steps. So, the step first, we have to identify the forward path. Means how many forward paths we have in this signal flow graphs. Now, see here. Forward path is the path which goes from input node to the output node. So here, input node is x1, output node is x5. See the direction, x1 to x2, these three are incoming, so the signal will not go there, this is outgoing. So x1 to x2, x2 to x3. Now from x3 we have two outgoing signals, one is from A3 4, one is with gain A3 4, and second is with gain A3 5. So here we are getting two paths which is going to the output node. So we have total two forward paths. And the forward paths are represented by P. So let us say the first forward path P1 is having the gain as A1 2, A2 3, A3 4, and A4 5. Here we are following the path as X1, X2, X3, X4, and X5. This is the path that we have followed. That is X1, X2, X3, X4, X5. A straight line from input node to the output node. Second forward path, that is P2, this is equals to A1 to A2 3, and this is the second path. So we use this as A3 5. And the path that we have used is X1, X2, X3, X5. X1 to X2, the gain is A1 to X2 to X3, the gain is A2 3. X3 to x5, the gain is a3, 5. So these are the product of branches. Again, product of branches gain traveling from input node to the output node, that is in the forward path. That is step first. Now step second, that is to determine depth. And for this, we need to have an individual loop, two non-touching loops, three non-touching loops, four non-touching loops, depending on the how many combinations that we have over here. So first of all, we will see the individual loops. Now find out the individual loops. This is one loop. This is another loop, second. This is third loop. This one is fourth loop, and here this is fifth loop. That means we are having total 5 number of individual loops. So total 5 loops are there, which comes under the category of individual loops. And these are represented as, since we are talking about the individuals, so we will mark this as 1. And here the next one is number 1. So L11 is equals to, we will write the gain, A23, A32. So the first is A23, A32. And the path that we have used is x2, x3, x2. So this is the first individual loop which has the gain L11, loop gain L11 equals to A23, A32. This A23, A32. And the path which we have used is x2, x3, and then back to the x2. Then the second one is L21. This one represents the individual. The second one is representing the type of loop, its individual loop. Then two non-touching loop will have this as 2. For 3, it will have 3. And these are the number of loops that we have in this category. So this is second loop gain of the category number 1, that is individual loop. So L21, this is given as A23, this multiply by A34 multiply by A32. This is A4, 2. It is going from X2 to X3, so the gain is A23. X3 to X4, the gain is A34. X4 to X2, so it is A4, 2. The path which we have used is X2, X3, X4, back to X2. So this is the path that we have used. Then the third one is L31. X2, X3, X4, X5, and then X2. So the gain is A23, A34, A42. This is A23, A34, and then sorry, this is A45. A23, A34, A45. Then back to X2, that is A52. So these are the gains. A23 is the gain between X2 and X3. A34 is the gain between X3 and X4. A45 is the gain between X4 and X5, and A52 is the gain between X5 and X2. So the path that we have used over here, that is X2, X3, X4, X5, and back to X2. So these are the three loop gains. Now the fourth one is L41. This L41, we have this as X2 to X3, that is A23. Then X3 to X5, so this is A35. And X5 back to the X2, so it is A52. The path which we have used is X2, X3, X5, then back to X2. A23 is a gain between X2 and X3. A35 is a gain between X3 and X5. A52 is the gain between X5 and X2. And the path that we have followed is X2, X3, X5, and back to the X2. And the last one, that is L51, this is self gain, that is A44. This is A44, same gain, that is X4 to X4. This is the path. So these are the total 5 individual loops that we have in this single flow graph. Now we'll see the possible combinations of two non-touching loops.
Will be 1 minus all these terms will be 0,
So 0 plus 0 plus 0 plus 0 plus 0 plus these two are also touching the same, so it will be 0 plus 0. So here we are going to have this delta 1 as 1. Similarly, this is delta k. So delta 2, this is equals to 1 minus. The second one is a12, a23, a35. a12, a23, a35. So in this case, this is the loop which is not touching the forward path, and the rest of the loops are touching the forward path number 2. So in this case, we have this loop, that is self loop, which is not touching to this forward path. So that we need to consider, that is L51. So here we are going to have this value as 0 plus 0 plus 0 plus 0 plus the gain, you will have this as L51, that is the collinear loop, this A44. So this will be A44 plus, again these are touching loops, so it will be 0, 0. So delta 2, we are going to have it as 1 minus A44. So this is delta 2, this is delta 1. Now the next one, that is step 4, we will use the Mason's gain formula. You know that the transfer function is given as summation k, here k value is 2, pk del k over del, which is equals to p1 del 1 plus p2 del 2 divided by del. And this is basically del. Del equals to 1 minus L11, L12, L13, L14, L51 plus L12, L22. And for del k, we need to have all these loops, all this value of del, which is not touching this p1 and p2. So we need to substitute the values of p1 del 1, p2 del 2, and del. We have obtained the expression for p1, we will take this p1. We have the expression for p2, so we will take this p2. We have the expression for delta 1, that is equals to 1. We have the expression for delta 2, that is equals to 1 minus A44. And delta is over here. So we need to substitute all this value in this expression. So that will give the values for delta. So we'll substitute it over here and we'll have the final result. So let's substitute these values. So the overall transfer function Tf equals to T, that is equals to this P1 delta 1, P1 is A12, A23, A34, A45. This is P1 multiplied by del 1, del 1 is 1, so it remains as it is. Plus P2 del 2, P2 is A12, A23, A35 multiplied by del 2, that is 1 minus A44. So this is P1 del 1 and P2 del 2 divided by del. And we know the expression for del. Del is 1 minus, just now we have seen, all the sum of all the individual loops L11, L21, L31, L41 plus L51 plus we have the two non-touching loops, that is L12 plus L22. So that we need to add over here. So we will write here, it is 1 minus L11 is A23, A32 plus L21 is A23, A34, A42, that is L21, plus L31, that is A23, A34, A45, A52. This is L31, that is this value. Then L41 plus A23, A35, A52. Plus L51, that is A44, plus two non-touching loops. We have seen that the non-touching loops are L11 and L51. So this is A23, A32, A44. Plus, we have seen the second one, that is L41 and L51, that is A23, A35, A52 multiplied by A44. So basically, this is the overall transfer function of the system that were designed by those four linear algebraic equations. Now here, by using those four linear algebraic expressions, we have converted into a signal flow graph. Then we have obtained all these informations which was required for the finding of the transfer function by using the Meissen's gain formula. We have obtained the forward pass. There are two forward paths, that is V1 and V2. In step 7, we have determined the delta. For delta, we will have to know the values for the initial loops. So we have seen that in this signal flow graph, we have to find loops. So we have obtained all the products of gain for this illusion loops, that is L11, L21, L31, L41 and L51. Then we have also seen about the two non-touching loops. We have found that there are two sets of, or two possible combinations of two non-touching loops. That is this loop with this, that is a loop x2, x3, x2 and x4, x4. And second one is x2, x3, x5, x2 with x4, x4. That is L11 with L51 and L41 with L51. Then we have found the delta. Delta expression is this, that is 1 minus L11, 1 minus sum of individual loops gain plus product, sum of product of two non-touching loops, combination of two non-touching loops. So here we have 5 combinations of individual loops, and here we have 2 combinations, possible combinations of two non-touching loops. And we have seen that there are no 3 non-touching loops or 4 non-touching loops. Then we have substituted these values inside the transfer function expression given by the Meissen's gain formula, that is transfer function equals to summation k equals to 2 pk del k over del, and we have substituted this value and we have obtained the resultant like this: a12 a23 a34 a45 plus a12 a23 a35 multiplied by 1.1 minus a44 divided by this del. So this is the final result of this signal flow graph. That was the representative graphical representation of that algebraic equation. So this is the way how we are going to use the signal flow graph methods and the Meissen's gain formula for obtaining the transfer function. In the next lecture, we will see the type 2. Thank you.